You in action.
Jackson from behind. Oh, clever play. Jackson maybe should have handballed that one. Alex to have a kick at the goals. He put it through. A great goal by Mark Jackson. And up go the arms and a little dance. Ah, well, he is, you've got to admit it, he is very entertaining.
Jackson and Pickett. Jacko has been doing it with one hand. Can he do it this time? Go, Jacko! He's done it. Then look at him. Allah be praised. What a great game he's played. Oh! Jacko. Jacko's looking for 15. He's not going to get it.
15.
He's got it. Got it. Oh. And there's the new trick. That's the one we've been promising you for weeks. Jacko has done it.
Witness, he's away to Kelvin Moore. Tell him all about it, Mark. Oh, that's it, Jacko. Pass on the message. What a character. What a character. He's a one-man band down there.
Goodness.
Oh, dear. He is a one-man show down there. He's as happy as Larry, kicked his first goal, and he has told about 15,000 people in no uncertain manner. Oh! Oh, dear.
Jacko's performing down there again. There he goes. I reckon Perry Brothers Circus need a new clown. Maybe he can get the job. We paid? No, it won't. Bit of acting, the umpire said. Kicked off the ground by Walsh. Runs goes in. And the chance there for Waddell, he went down under the weight of the Essendon Guernsey, and now the umpire said a free kick will go the way of Merv Neagle. Oh, a headbutt!
It's gone off. That's silly play, Neagle. That is stupid. Stupid football.
That should have been a report, and I think it will be a report. The umpire's thinking about it.
Yep.
So Geelong set to hit the front, which they do. It's a goal to Jacko. First blood to the Cats, and that came up inside the minute mark.
Jacko now going mad, and of course, the next thing he'll do will go back to young Morris and try and put him off his game with some sort of a fairy walk or an ape trance or whatever he goes into. Now, watch him go down here to young Morris. There he goes now. He's told Morris, that's one for you, son. And Morris overruns the ball. It's a chance for Jacko again. Weaves his way through the pack, snaps at goal. There's a chance for his second. It's bouncing the right way. Oh, just watch him go mad there. Look at him, look. Look at Jacko putting on his best performance for them.
The Jacko Show, 1985.
Well, young Morris a bit stiff that time, but he misread the bounce of the ball.
Ah, Jacko was too good, Luke. This will be the easiest goal he'll kick. No, Jacko's on his own. With a bit of plaster. Come on, come and get it, guys. The Jacko Show.
Salmon onto the ball. Sandy is Jackson now. Runs around his man, plays on. It's a nice looking kick from Jackson. It's a goal!
And Geelong are in front.
Not anything's worth a try at this stage of the game.
Oh dear, now I know why you went into movies, Jacko. It stands out a mile, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. But,
back memories?
Yeah, it does. You know, I really enjoyed my football time until the very last, it was a blow up at Princess Park against Hawthorn, which really put an end to my game. I think before that, I think that I gave good value to the people that came and watched, and I think that a lot of footballers overlook that when they take the field. And I think the AFL at the time, you know, was short of characters in the game, so they gave me a little bit of a run. But I offered my services after that year when that big blow-up came, and I eventually left Geelong to the Sydney Swans for actually I was going to go up there and play for nothing and Fitzroy. And directives, as I understand it, came down that wouldn't allow me to go to either of those clubs. Now, I don't know where that came from, but, of course, that was back in the good old days when it was the VFL. So that was one of the points why I left the game. But after that incident, I faced the tribunal, and I got reported 8 times in that particular game, which I wasn't proud of, but, yeah. You know, I was prepared to cop a week for each one.
Yeah.
And I was working for Willisie at the time, and they were having a party, and there was an old sports reporter there, and after the tribunal, the very day after my dad died of a heart attack, and the sports reporter actually came up to me and he said that, you know, your dad was a good bloke, but you brought that heart attack on, and people haven't seen me at the footy since that day. So it was very disappointing.
Yeah, can I ask you one thing seriously? And you said how, you know, and you did, you brought personality back into the game, Jacko. Was it contrived? Did you go out, did you have a... To me, there always seemed to be, there was a Jacko plan.
Yep.
You know, because you're not a blockhead. You know you can make money. Was that the aim?
Well, you know, so many times through junior football, you hear, you know, you're just treated like a piece of meat, and you're pushed and shoved, and you're virtually guided right in, right through your junior football, which is no more, thanks to the current administration of the AFL, no more under-19s. And I think that is the breeding ground. So many guys are proud to pull on an under-19 jumper and go back and play for the rest of their career. But, yeah, I had a plan which I executed, and the first thing I wanted to do, and after the first game I played, I was a little bit disappointed because I'd put so many years playing Saturday and Sunday through my junior year, starting at the age of 12 and finally making it at 21. I ran out into the ground and I thought, gee, is this all there is to it? I was a very aggressive junior footballer, and if I would have followed that tack, I would have been pushed out of the game very soon, like guys like Robert Muir and Phil Carman. And so I thought I'd try comedy, and that's what I did. But I mean, even though you try comedic things on the ground, you've got to be able to get the ball in the first place, and you can't do it when the ball's in your half of the field because you've got to concentrate on what you're doing. And that's how I went about it. I had a plan. The first thing was to get Australia thinking that I was an idiot. I successfully did that, and since then I've just been underwriting it ever since by going out and doing sports nights and sports talks and seminars and talking about football and sport and how you go about exploiting the chances that you get. And unless you do that, I'm afraid you're going to be very disappointed at the end of it.
Can I say, ask in closing, do you want to continue to be an idiot, or do you want to now, I mean, obviously with this gold mining business and the acting career, are we going to see a serious Mark Jackson, the businessman?
You know, that was a certain section of my life that I had great fun doing and executing. And now I'm in the business arena, and hopefully all those things can sort of help. And you've just got to draw up another plan, and people will just have to wait and see.
Jacko, yes, thank you very much.
We will look out. Full of energy, Sandy.
We'll look out for Signal One.
And look out for the big float from Dolcon Gold.
Yes,
so, and I'll make you some money, and I'll make all the sporting public some money.
You could sell snow to the Eskimos, ladies and gentlemen. Great to catch up with you. Mark Jackson, thank you very
much. Thanks very much.
Good on you, Jacko. We shall take a break and then be back with one of the classic home and away games.